ranked and undefeated North Carolina with their last tough test before ACC play against one of the best in the Big Ten, Michigan State, playing just a short ride from home. A showdown in Motown in the ACC Big Ten Challenge. Only loss was down in Orlando to Maryland. They got beat by 18 and then bounced back after that with wins over Oklahoma State and Wichita State as Hansbrough gets the alley-oop to go.
I mean, you talk about the elite players in a nation. We talked about it last
time. Morgan's got a chance to be one of the best players in the Big Ten. Hansbrough is knocked down hard to the floor, lost the ball. Ellington comes up with it in the corner and buries the three.
I'll tell you, with a shooter like that, you got to go out and extend your defense. And Homer is from the Motor City, played at Redford High School, good athlete. I love the way that Fraser swings the ball.
Green, soft touch and gets the bounce. Danny Green has now made 18 of the 32 threes that he has taken this season.
I'll tell you, he was brilliant in their last game when they won that game easily over North Carolina Asheville.
Yep, and he had 20 points twice out in Maui against good competition. Summers, tough shot from deep in the corner. A long two for Darrell Summers, a sophomore out of Detroit.
Yeah, he's excited playing here in the Motor City.
He can
flat out shoot the rock, baby. He had six in a row, didn't he, in the last game?
Yep, the building tonight.
Well, I figure I got some guys right there that can step in.
Good position inside. Gray backing down. Hansbrough lost it. Seventh turnover, make it eight turnovers now, committed by Michigan State. Carolina's already got 9 points off him.
He made a nice catch, but they deflected that ball.
Green spinning, dumps it off. Thompson open for the jumper. Boy, Deion Thompson is a much improved player this year.
Well, you know, he gets a lot of space. He said, well, let you shoot the jumper. And I'll tell you one thing, Tyler Hansbrough has improved that jump shot.
Davis inside. He's a lefty, makes the most of it. The 6'10 freshman out of Richmond, Virginia, a tenacious rebounder. Lucas, and a block at the other end by Davis.
I'll tell you, Davis, one of those underrated freshmen. Look at that fast break. They can score off the turnover. They score off the block shot created by Davis, and they fill the with the reputation of being a big-time shooter.
And he is the biggest reason Michigan State is right there with Carolina. Hansbrough bangs it in off the glass.
What a great drop step. I tell you, all those guys that don't think he can play at the next level, forget about it.
Oh, Raymar Morgan missed a chippy. He got in all alone to the rim and couldn't lay it in. The pull-up by Drew at the other end. Banks in at two, had a foot on the line.
You know, his dad played in the NBA for years, coaches now. That level as an assistant.
Allen off the screen, and he was backpedaling before it even hit net.
Said, anything you guys can do, I can do better. Allen finally showing that shooting ability that everybody talked about.
Sophomore out of Lawrenceville, Georgia. What a night he is having with 13 points already.
And not against Cupcake City.
No.
And not against Cupcake City, my friend. This against the number one team in America.
Undefeated Carolina at 7-0. Davis.
Big time.
Again, the lefty, so he turns to the right shoulder. The jump hook low, as you are right now. Back when you were coaching right in this town.
Right in this town. Yeah. Had a lot of fun in this town. A lot of beautiful people. I don't know, Dan. I really, like I said, the initial reaction is, wow, look at him shooting the ball.
Ty Lawson, another deep three.
The initial reaction is, you say, he's done, finished, but you know what? You think about it. Sometimes these are kids. They make an emotional mistake. I salute Billy Gillespie, giving him a second opportunity.
How about Ty Lawson? 9 points, 5 assists, 4 steals, and 15 minutes of action. There are not many point guards in his league in America.
Well, if you're picking the All-American guards right now, today, which you're not going to do, because there's so much basketball, but today would be Lawson and Curry.
A missed shot, a run out, a dunk for Ellington.
They are so
in transition.
They are so unbelievable in transition, this basketball team. This is a talented at Purdue. They were absolutely sensational.
Ty Lawson misses a deep three. Offensive rebound. Green blocked by Rowe. Hansbrough and one.
You know, blocked by Rowe, but look where the ball ends up. It ends up in the hands of the all-solid goal All-American Tyler Hansbrough, and he knows how to finish. I want him on my team. I know a lot of guys say, oh, the NBA, I don't know if he's quick enough, the 24-second clock, up and down. Forget about it. This kid will get 14. Can't wait to see Michael Wilmot, a terrific guy.
Lucas, what a recovery. Danny Green with a block and a save. Carolina is playing at an unbelievably high level.
Fame said to me they will be one of the great backcourts in basketball. Oh, Jam City. Little Jam City.
Off the inbounds play. Graves from
lot of Spartan fans were really hoping this would be the year that the Spartans would really get it together and make that journey to the Final Four and play right here at home. Wow.
Steal by Thompson. Count the bucket for Lawson. This is unbelievable. I mean, it's one thing for North Carolina to come in here and win, but they are humiliating the Spartans.
Yeah, they're really running up and down the court, just totally dominating. I mean, they got a makeup of a pro franchise. I mean, they really do. Look at Rasheed. He said, oh, my guys. They're my guys. Look at him dressed in that Carolina blue from out of Philadelphia. Joe Holiday on that bench does an outstanding job. That's a look at Tyler. They didn't think he was going to play. And old did he play. Now get a little time off. Shows that he can shoot that jump shot. Dick Weiss, who knows, look at the way he's getting back defensively. I got to believe he feels he let his team down here. Didn't give him the kind of performance they needed.
Drew, and he buries the three. That was Lucas's guy, too. He got caught looking to the ball handler, and Drew buried the open three.
See, the only chance they would have to win in this game started
a while ago.
It has been over for a long, long time.
Number one, wow. North Carolina puts a beating on Michigan State, 98-63, and the ACC wins its 10th ACC Big Ten Championship.
The stage is set for Psycho T, a mark that has stood for 30 years could fall tonight. Tyler Hansbrough is just 9 points away from breaking Phil Ford's all-time scoring record at North Carolina. The reigning National Player of the Year chases history tonight in Chapel Hill. There is a buzz in town tonight here in Chapel Hill surrounding Tyler Hansbrough. He is on the verge of becoming the all-time leading scorer at North Carolina. Phil Ford in attendance tonight to watch him break the mark, perhaps number one North Carolina hosting the University of Evansville, along with Len Elmore and Lenny.
About winning in that system, and Phil will be the first one to tell you he'd sacrifice even more points if it came down to more wins.
Hansbrough turnaround, 15-footer, he rattles it home. He's got four in the game. He's five away from the mark. Point.
Evansville is not a great shooting team. Got a couple of good shooters from the outside, but they've got a lot of guys play mid-range.
Add two more. Hansbrough with six and just three away.
And I don't know if it's coincidence or if it's actual, but Carolina kind of bogged down a little bit. Well, not really.
That's a deuce. His foot was inside the line, so he's got 8 points in the game. His mom, Tammy, loves it. He's just one away from the record. He has just tied Phil Ford. And Larry Drew, the second off the bench. Ellington out top gets the screen, and a hard one from Hansbrough. Looked for him on the roll, and he wasn't looking.
Perfect example. Even though Hansbrough was open, Tyler Hansbrough, night in, night out, when Wayne Ellington gets that mid.
I said, you know, Dad, it's no big deal. Stay at home. But Gene told me he knew all along he would be here. Now, he made eye contact with Tyler minutes before tip, but that's been their only communication so far. Maybe celebration right now.
Operating on the block, and there it is. The record. Tyler Hansbrough is the new scoring leader at North Carolina.
That basket, Tyler Hansbrough is now the all-time leading scorer in basketball history. Tyler has 2,292 points, breaking the previous record of 2,290 set 30 years ago by the great Phil Ford. Ladies and gentlemen, at this time, let's roll.
Little slip of the screen. And, of course, always facing the double teams, using that upper body strength. How characteristic. It wasn't a three. It wasn't an easy layup. It was the kind of baskets that have come to mark the play of Tyler Hansbrough.
Roy Williams this afternoon. History in the first half. All the great names in the history of North Carolina basketball. I mean, it's a who's who in the ACC and overall in hoops. Phil Ford entered as the all-time leading scorer. He won't leave here tonight as that. It'll be Tyler Hansbrough on top. 46-28, your halftime scores. We join Kevin Negandhi for the K. The all-time leading scorer in North Carolina basketball. Top of the list with the effort here tonight. 91-73, your final score in hands.
He's had a fantastic career to date, and congratulations, Tyler. You deserve it.
First of all, to my teammates and my coaches, and Coach Williams, when he recruited me, I never dreamed I'd be here, being the all-time leading scorer at, you know, such a great university that I love to represent.
Tyler, man, 3 years ago when we were freshmen riding our bikes around Chapel Hill, I would have never guessed you were going to be Carolina's all-time leading scorer. But congrats, man. You've worked for everything you have, and you deserve it.
Well, as Antoine, I want to congratulate you. Next year, you know, you have to do it up against me. But once again, congratulations on the record. You represent Carolina Blue the way it should be represented. You're in the history books, bro. Congratulations.
There was a mutual respect there. It never got to the point where he had to give me a tee.
The full court pressure for Carolina almost creates the turnover. Instead, it's Fields. And coming down court, Green gets the block.
Wow. Whoops. Holy smokes. Whistled one over the backboard. Happy New Year's.
Mark Fox might get run. He is livid. He went up the sideline and was out of control.
How about Danny Green?
Block.
That's a clean block, a Spalding sandwich, all leather. Watch this. No body. Danny Green looked like Superman or Batman. Give him a cape.
North Carolina. And one more time, let's take a look at the Danny Green block.
Well, the Danny Green superhero. Look how far back he comes. He's behind half court, recovers, just a complete clean, what I call Spalding sandwich. That is remarkable.
Finally, it's Armand Johnson to finish.
Well, the Wolfpack playing a little volleyball on the backboard there, just keeping the ball alive. A spirited effort on the glass.
It's crowd at the Lawler Event Center isn't giving up yet. Count the bucket plus the foul for Lawson.
Well, once again, Ty Lawson takes the ball into traffic. Low dribble, almost like a Marcus Haynes, the way he's able to weave in and out and between defenders. And then the ability to finish. I go back to what Coach Holiday, Joe Holiday, a North Carolina assistant for Roy Williams, talked about. There's a high ball screen. He opts to go opposite the screen and able to draw the foul and get the finish.
Carolina team that has already lost twice in ACC play. Games in some awfully quiet games. They need him to play big against Hansbrough tonight.
Well, I'll tell you one thing, they've really played well here in the first 9 minutes of this game. Oh, no contact. No contact.
Danny Green credited with a block shot. A spectacular recovery by Green.
Yeah, Green did a terrific job rotating back. And the Carolina faithful really applaud. Did a great job coming back defensively on a good angle. There he is at a good angle. He's got all ball. Yep. He's got all ball.
So we'll keep an eye on that. McGowan has been good so far. Thompson not looking for the pass. Hurdle block from behind by Green.
I tell you, Green has made two sensational defensive plays. Does he think his name is Michael Jordan? Does he think he's Jordan? That's a Jordan-ish play. Coming, Danny Green making some terrific plays. Listen, and Ellington have gotten a secret.
Graham nearly slipped, kept his dribble alive.
He's really an energetic guy.
Is.
He plays with a lot of passion, a lot of feeling.
Lawson working hard. McClinton lost it.
Terrific
Carolina's
play.
Got it.
Terrific play by Lawson. Terrific play by Lawson. Vision doesn't stand up. They're called with the walk-in violation. Has good presence of mind. He would love it, and if he has a bad game, trying to get out of that mental attitude rather than just let it go and return to what he's capable of doing.
No wine and cheese feel in this building right now, and they've got it again.
Turnover City, a champ. Champ City. The Heels get after it now. I got it down to three.
Two turnovers, two dunks.
And people other than Tyler Hansbrough.
Stem the tide a little bit, but Dick, Carolina, Frank Cave's worst nightmare, turning turnovers into baskets at the other end.
Yeah, that's what he joked about to us before the game. We got to eliminate that. Well, they don't eliminate it there. That's the easiest deuce that Hansbrough will get it all night. And here goes another easy deuce. A little jam, and the Heels are back. In terms of reflecting his personality.
Well, if you're looking at Miami as maybe team number five right now.
Florida State, keep an eye on them.
And Miami has won at Kentucky. Hansbrough, by the way, has 20 points already. Miami's won at Kentucky, at Boston College, couple quite like he did before the injuries a couple of years ago. Almost threw it away. Davis Fearn, the lefty. No. Graham had it. Davis and Carolina leads.
I tell you, Davis has been the star of stars off that bench for North Carolina. Something they have needed. The free throw line has been so good to them. They have got much more production on the free throw line than Miami.
Just about 3.5 seconds separating the game clock and shot clock.
Oh, that's a charge.
It's two bad decisions by Graham. Committing the foul, and they could have run it down, held for a last shot. And how about Tyler Hansbrough in the first half that he's had with 20 points already?
I tell you, he's been dominant on the interior right out of the get-go. Plays so hard. He's getting great post position. They're really basically playing a one-on-one on the interior, and that'll be a field day for him. He's worked hard on making that open jump shot.
Now Miami, after the mistake, they give Carolina all kinds of time here for a last shot.
They jump into a zone. Change defense.
Danny Green.
Oh, Danny Green gets the open look.
What a swing at the end of the half. Carolina closes the half on a 13-0 run.
You think they got momentum on his side? Uncle Mo is in the Tar Heel locker room. Now the question is, do they come out in the first game? You got to be able to handle the ball. You got to make open shots. You got to defend.
He's got two field goals tonight, and they have both been on dunks.
Is
knocked away
zone?
By Collins.
They're zoning. He should be effective. He should be effective against the zone. His shot has disappeared for a period of this year. Interior pass, finding the open man. This is a good Miami team. This is a good Miami team.
Ellington again.
Oh, yes. Ellington. He could be back. And, oh, that could certainly make that coaching staff smile. If he comes back, the Duke with that J, watch out for the heel.
Who can stretch a defense with the best of them? McClinton with 17.
He said, I like to take out a shootout with Mr. Ellington. Uh-oh.
Ellington again.
Uh-oh. He's got the Hubert Davis rhythm now. Hubert striking it up there in the game day room. He's got the stroke like Hubert had when he played here.
How is he so wide open two straight times down the court? To dominance here in the last few minutes.
Well, it's been the Ellington show. There it is. He drains the jumper. And now he goes with the wide open J. Look at a great arc on that shot. And there's the last one. Not the mud nylon, baby. The one thing Miami's done a superb job, getting back defensively, making them play 5-on-5.
Green knew he missed it, and he runs it down. What a great hustle play. Lawson for three.
I'll tell you, this kid can shoot the three. Everybody questioned his shot. He can shoot the three. If he squares his body, gets a good look. I think I may put, when you look at the SEC, when I'm looking right now, I might have Kentucky in my top 25. I think they're an improved team, especially the way Meeks is playing. Oh, he's playing well.
All of a sudden, he can't miss.
Can't miss, and it makes them a different team. When that guard combo gets coaches getting jobs over at Kmart, Walmart.
Collins double-teamed, open man hurdle. Nowhere to go. Good defense by Davis. What a spark he's given them tonight. Lawson, Ellington.
Why not? Why not go to your buddy? Lawson says, hey, Elton and I are going to make some music here. Like the King of Jazz did, Duke Ellington, he made some sweet.
Collins.
Great effort right there to keep his presence. Also, great penetration by McLean. I'll tell you one thing, he's just not a catch and shoot guy.
You know.
Are you kidding me?
They might want to guard him.
But you know, he was really pressured there in a way. That was not an easy shot. That was in his face.
Second half threes for Ellington. Shot. Second half story, Dick, as we mentioned, Wayne Ellington.
It's been Wayne Ellington. It's been his shooting ability. That's a great reputation that he came in with. It was a good offensive rebound. But this is what he does best when he really has his rhythm. The Hubert Davis kind of stroke. The great arc, the follow through, squares his body. Great bounce off the floor, good rhythm, and he's got a smile.
Our entire Saturday prime package. This is the first of eight. Next week, we're going to be up in South Bend as Notre Dame hosts Connecticut. What an environment that should be.
Digger Phelps will have everybody down at Stanley Parisi's. I mean, are you kidding? The kid's showing why. Howard Garfinkel said a terrific shooter when he came out of the Scholastic ranks. And he's showing it here tonight. These Cardinals are going to win that game. Cardinals and Steelers.
Jones misses the three, and that is all. North Carolina beats Miami by 17 to go to 16-2 on the season, 2-2 in the league. The Canes fall to 13-4, also 2-2 in the league.
Never affects you, though, I can tell you that.
Well, I'm not wearing a mouth guard either.
Lawson against the double team. Look at that speed.
He should love seeing the kind of traps.
You'd think.
Ellington, great backdoor pass to the cutting Green. North Carolina on top for the first time tonight.
I think we're going to start to see Ellington really. He's got to be able to help Tyler Hansbrough so defenses can't just constantly pack it in against Hansbrough.
Stiff, bad pass. Great steal by Ellington. Not known for his defense. He got that one.
He's playing well, Mike. He really is playing well. And I think a lot of that comes from the feeling mentally that he's not struggling as much offensively. They're going to get Booker in back. Booker's too good, too strong. Leads the conference in block shots. He's a 15-point scorer.
Stiff, nice drive. Thompson rejected it. Maybe they can get him on track with Hansbrough out. But here,
as I said earlier, Ellington really liked seeing Clemson. He had 36 in an overtime game. Averaged 29 in the three meetings against Clemson.
He's lit them up.
Rivers got it back. Blocked again. Green blocked him twice.
I tell you,
in the ball game,
Oliver
this is Rivers.
Oliver Pennell has done a solid job as the Clemson leader.
Stiff, blocked by Green. Ahead to Lawson. Numbers got the roll and a blocking foul as well.
All created off the block shot by Green. Green has done a really terrific job defensively. So I'm in that Miami game with two sensational block shots. There's the block shot. And they're going to go up, up, and away. There's the little handoff. He gets the roll. Trying to force him away from the basket.
Here comes the double team. Leaves Potter open for three. Thompson. Carolina ball on the save. Lawson ahead of the pack.
What a great look.
Thompson.
What a great look, though, by Lawson. The little shovel pass, the jam, and the Tar Heel faithful jump with joy.
We are tied for the seventh time.
It's a great game.
Right through the legs of Booker.
Uh-oh.
Lawson got it. The foul.
That's what Oliver Purnell said today. North Carolina cannot be allowed to do, and that's get run out easy baskets.
Yeah, I can't turn it over when it can get those numbers, and especially if Lawson gets the ball in transition. What a nice shovel pass. The trailer, communique. St. Mary's, Randy Bennett's got a great one hit. Mills, you think about Stephon Curry, who really has to do it all for Davidson.
Young double team, Ellington ahead. Young dribbles into a trap and turns it over.
open man or take it by himself.
Try to isolate him on that side of the court, and they do.
You're right, Coach. Coach Patrick, a little isolation. I like that out of you.
Lawson used a lot of time.
They got it to Ellington, and he knocks down the three.
Uncle Mo goes to the locker room with the Tar Heels.
Ellington, 16 points, 5 assists. Lawson, 11 points and 5 assists. A big first half for the North Carolina backcourt.
Little isolation. He's trying to make like Phil Ford. Remember Phil Ford? Got a better idea. Ford was dynamite with the ball as a point guard. And then Lawson. He likes this. A little showtime. He's showing his ball handling skills. He's waiting for his buddy to get free. His sidekick. So where are you, Wade? And it's King Wade. It's King Wade.
Let's check in with Heather.
On that perimeter shot, and then I asked about any adjustments against Terrence Oglesby and those 17 points, and he joked, yeah, let's play better.
Let's go.
Right, Heather, great ball movement that time, and Carolina gets its own rebound, and the Heels come out getting the first two buckets and have their biggest lead.
That's a danger zone. If I'm with Roy Williams, I'm concerned about one area. My starters have scored every point with the exception of a deuce by Larry Drew. For the year, they're second in the nation, averaging 92 points a game, Mike. The starters have scored 73 of them.
Booker powers his way in there. And at some point, they're going to need the scoring off the bench. Ellington.
He loves Clemson. Averaging 29 a game against the Tigers. You can see the
hole. Those threes that were falling in the first half, not dropping now.
He is so strong. So strong, Mike. He seals the defense off. Uncle Mo is on the side of the Tar Heels.
North Carolina has beaten Clemson 53 straight times here. May have gotten away with a little hook. And the first bucket for Sykes, the starting center. Ellington, great dish to Thompson.
Tell you, Ellington and Lawson passing the ball so well. And Thompson, the recipient. Nice elite programs in the nation.
No back off in Rick Barnes, was there? Frazier ahead of the pack.
They gotta get
fouled.
Gotta get Frazier involved. That's good for his confidence. They beat the pressure, get the open layup. Steve Robinson.
Devastating.
I tell you, Mike, in his defensive plays he made against Miami was sensational.
Yeah. Very long. Young, good head fake. Grant with a rebound and then lost it. Ellington against Oglesby and got it. Ellington having a heck of a night. 23 points, and you pointed out earlier, Dick, when he sees Clemson orange, he lights it up.
Oh, really?
Mark in his last game against Miami.
He wants to play a little street music like Duke did. There he is, showing his range as a shooter. And he's going to show his passing ability, great vision, then defensive ability in a passing lane, and converts. And now he's working on the offensive boards. He said, what else do you want me to do? Well, I'll show you. I'll shoot the little medium range jumper as well.
How about a career?
But you know what?
With a miss.
North Carolina's capable of doing this against anybody in America when they have their A game.
Carolina will go to 17-2. Clemson will fall to 16-2 after a 94-70 win here in Chapel.
And I think it's not that they're not trying to throw it in there. That's their first option. The defense by Florida State has just been outstanding on the perimeter. And when you're covered up so tightly on the perimeter, it's hard to find the guys.
Yeah, it's like a quarterback that can't get to a secondary receiver because of a pass rush.
And then when you have an offensive player like Duggar.
Oh, look at that steal by the most valuable heel. Yes, and a foul. Kitchen picks it up. And a chance for an old-fashioned three-point play.
See, Kitchen needed to let that one go.
Boy, Danny Green with a dagger.
This is just a great steal by Danny Green. Kitchen didn't step to the pass. And then Kitchen compounds the mistake. Green now with 19 points.
His motor thing, Dan. He was a sixth man. There are a lot of great players in this league starting now that were sixth men last year. I mean, I can't think of Danny Green ever coming off the bench again.
Well, see, now if you're North Carolina, I think what you have to do is make somebody besides Tony Douglas beat you. Double team and make him give up the basketball. This is a bad matchup for North Carolina.
Yes, it is. Especially with Hansbrough playing with four. Douglas had to give up the dribble. Got a little help from Danny Green, did Hansbrough. Shot clock winding down. Hansbrough got a touch. Knocked it away. All Douglas all the time. Off the back iron. The rebound to Singleton. And a fresh 35. And only a 3-second discrepancy between the shot clock and the game clock.
See, Leonard Hamilton, I think, doesn't want to call timeout just yet, because he's got that matchup with Hansbrough against Douglas, although Hansbrough did an outstanding job against Douglas.
He's going to call with 15 on the shot clock a timeout, or 14. Well, he does now with 12.
Well, he called. He wanted to wait, but then he waited until Lawson switched back on Douglas.
The table in December might be staring at their third conference loss, and we haven't reached midseason as yet. We shall see.
Well, and they were up by 13 points.
That's right.
You don't often see them lose that kind of a lead in a half.
All right, here's Douglas. Look for the penetration that you were talking about. Again, it's Hansbrough checking him. And a shot clock violation. Again, Hansbrough did the number defensively, surprising Douglas. And it's North Carolina that has the ball.
There's got to be more time on the clock than that.
Yep. Highly unusual. They did lose a second. They lost a full second, Dan.
They did.
And that could make a difference. Lawson at the buzzer. Got it! Maybe not. Ty Lawson wins it at the buzzer. On a night when Tyler Hansbrough's 55-game streak of double digits or more, 10-plus points, came to an end, it was his defense that allowed Lawson's offense to win it at the buzzer. He could care less about that 55-game streak.
Now, Tim, the officials, by rule, have to review that, although in looking at the replays we've shown you, it looks like that ball definitely was out of his hand. People talk
Tony Douglas.
Well, here's the end, what we're talking about with the clock. The ball clearly out of his hand before that clock went to zero, and that's the rule. It's got to be out of his hand before the clock goes to zero.
This game when they were down three. Well, that three-point play.
And here's the shot that ends the game. But another thing that I'll tell you, Tim, is that on Florida State's last possession, who was it who came up huge with a defensive play? It was Tyler Hansbrough, again matched up against Tony Douglas.
Green, Ellington captures it, and here's Lawson. Green wants the three.
Steve, he has been a very aggressive looking for that shot in the last couple of games. 15 attempts from behind the arc.
By Lawson, Waylon Ellington, and Danny Green. Here's Thompson. This is Ellington out beyond the three.
Well, that's the thing. Maryland is going to have to trap and attack and get turnovers out front. If they don't come up with the ball, they're going to be. And Maryland has somehow got to force them to miss and then clean up the glass.
Vasquez out front. And Hansbrough with the steal. Vasquez in tow. Hansbrough with a dunk.
You really can't afford to make lazy.
For Maryland. Mosley off the glass. Too hard. Frazier boards the miss. Ellington again open for three.
Hey, it looks like one of those big nights for Wayne Ellington. You know, you can just see the change in.
And the rebound gathered up by North Carolina. Deion Thompson. Drew. Green. Deeper three.
Well, he just brings such a unique skill set to the floor, Steve. I mean, he's an excellent three-point shooter. He's a shot clock.
And their offense is working and generating the open shot, but they just haven't been able to take advantage of it. Shooting about 43% as a team.
Worst in the league.
Lawson out front for three. Got it. Fifth three-pointer for the Tar Heels.
Roy Williams has asked him to be a more consistent three-point shooter, and he has been this year.
Inside, Dave Neal.
It's got to be a concern to Roy Williams about how quickly Maryland has been scoring in this game.
They've had three fast breaks before they can even take a victory lap. After, Lawson for three more.
After made baskets.
Yeah, that's tough when you're taking down to that play. Neal face guarded him. He's got
8 points. And back the other way, another one of those fast breaks, and Roy Williams is very upset.
Yeah, he is not happy with the way his team is defending right now.
Timeout on the court taken by the Tar Heels.
Well, that's what we talked about, Steve, that Maryland's best chance to score in this game is off the break and pushing the ball up the floor in the half court. The edge goes to North Carolina. North Carolina up by 10 with 7:55 to go, and Tyler Hansbrough, Steve, I really think he gets energized by plays like this when he hits the deck and he started attacking the rim. Able to do it two of the four this year off of the dribble. He's also expanded his game to knock that 18-foot shot down. 9 points for him, 3 or 4 from the line.
And he's moved to third among the ACC career scoring leaders, moving past Johnny Dawkins.
Screaming.
That's you. Oh, it's too bad.
Yeah.
Lawson, three from outside. I mean, you're just a speck in everything. Well, Deion Thompson with a rebound off the miss. First North Carolina foul of the evening. Here is Danny Green for three.
Well, that's a great pass right there by Bobby Fraser. You want to talk about getting a guy an open look, make a cross-court pass, and Danny Green had a wide open three.
Not. Field goal story is just about even. It's a 3-point field goal. It's a big difference for North Carolina. Here comes another. Danny Green has 4. North Carolina has 9.
And that's just not how Maryland's built. They're being outscored. I think in a game like this, you've got to have unsuspected heroes step up and contribute for you.
Ellington with a 3. It's the 10th. Ellington now 3 of 4. 2. Mosley inside, stripped to the ball. 4th turnover for the Terrapins. Drew Ellington, the trailer for 3. 11 3-pointers for the Tar Heels.
Well, it's a scary thing with
the free throw attempts. He's one of the top free throw shooters in the country, let alone the conference.
Well, Maryland's an excellent free throw shooting team. They just don't get there a lot.
First 3-pointer of the second half, and the 5th from the hand of Wayne Ellington. He's got 24. Up in the front court, Ellington watches the defender float by. Misses the 3. Green tries to tip the rebound. Who's got it? Hansbrough. Who else? Lawson for 3, dead on.
He just got lost out front.
And then looking beyond into the postseason, assuming at least one ACC tournament appearance in the NCAA possibly, that he could possibly pass J.J. Redick too. Ellington has passed everybody. That's the 14th three-pointer of the game for the Tar Heels. Ties a season mark that they have.
Battle in the paint.
Goes into Copeland. Milbourne battles him, but Copeland comes away with it. Hansbrough tries a 3.
Why not?
Yeah. 15 for the 9th for the Tar Heels. The first off the hand of Tyler Hansbrough, who has 24.
Well, and they've had a tough time. They've had some tough losses at home.
Hansbrough trying to move the ball to the baseline.
Arguably should have lost to this Maryland team.
Oh, yeah.
They were down 17 in that game.
Ellington with his 7th three of the day. 30 points.
And bad news for the rest of the conference if this continues.
Dupree. It's been coming. But finally, it's confirmed. He gets a pass out from Green for the dunk. 32 for Ellington. Lawson can't finish. Can Ellington do it? Why not? My word. 7 points in a minute for Wayne Ellington. And this one will end in the Tar Heels column. Him almost changed it up as Roy Williams and Gary Williams meet. A total offensive show by the Tar Heels tonight.
The passion, the intensity, the tradition. This backyard brawl brings together two of college basketball's most successful programs. Only 8 miles separates the two, but this is no neighborhood meeting. This is the Battle of the Blues. Spring-like temperatures have made it like a furnace inside. Carolina's made the trip down 15-501, and Duke was here to greet them. Duke students have been waiting a long time for this. For the 225th time, 3rd-ranked North Carolina and 6th-ranked Duke in Cameron Indoor Stadium. Carolina will have it first. This is Paulus on Lawson. Tune up in Carolina.
A big start for Deion Thompson, who hasn't been seeing a big basket. And I think
keep in mind, Green and Ellington have been on fire in the last several games from beyond the arc. Blue Devils extend their defense. Thompson again. Yes, sir.
Gets back and hustles and forces two misses.
Another steal. Thompson. There's Hansbrough all alone. Two Blue Devils on the floor. Shire's shaking up.
Well, Shire got landed on, but Duke so far has been very casual in North Carolina, taking advantage of shooting the gaps.
Tar Heels out of the gate in a hurry. 14-6. Four turnovers by Duke already. Thompson wants it. Goes on Zubek. Short jumper. Yes.
Ryan, that's what he'll try to do against Zubek. He doesn't have great foot.
With the bucket. Frazier for three. Bang.
Bobby Frazier's last eight games, 0 of 12 from three. But this is a different game tonight.
Points.
They want to try to run Henderson down in the low post, especially with a guy like Frazier on him who's overmatched physically.
Thompson. Bang. He's got 10.
He's playing like David Thompson in this game.
He's one off his average. We have 12:34 to play in the first half. Zubek. And Hansbrough with a rebound. Frazier. Has 6 points with those two three balls.
Yeah, that's great contributions off the bench too. And Frazier, you talk about it, a guy who hasn't been
29-18. Tar Heel, Shire for three.
That's a beautiful
this game. Paulus for three. Splash.
He hit
Frazier the crazy. He's alive. Frazier for three. Again, he's got 9, all from beyond the arc.
How about that? Nice. What contribution? He lost his dribble, but he saw Frazier wide open.
Singler answers.
It looks like 18-foot jump shots instead of getting into the paint where he can cause havoc.
Henderson with a great drive.
But Deion Thompson and Bobby Frazier would have had 19 of the 34 Carolina points.
Paulus for three.
Why?
Singler again. Run by the Duke Blue Devils. Lawson off balance answers.
Big play by their point guard. Saw his team was struggling, decided to take it on his shoulders and get his team a possession and a good layup.
Singler missed the dunk and walked. But he was fouled first. Paulus steps back for two.
He's been a different.
Henderson. Yes, sir. .140 to play in the first half. Singler. Nothing but net.
He is just such a difficult player to guard.
3 seconds to play in the first half. What a comeback by the Blue Devils. Three ball. Yes, sir. Again. Danny Green. Tar Heels led by 10. Duke went on a 22-5 run. 62% from the field for Duke.
This rival. rivalry is important for one reason and one reason alone. We have been out here busting our butts for 2 months in this disgusting, rat-infested swamp of a land for one reason and one reason alone. Because we're going to beat the Tar Heels, baby!
Well, they lead here at halftime. Gets it to Hansbro, ball's loose. Jump ball. Let's see what the discussion is.
The discussion is they're saying that Singler hit Hansbro as a reaction coming out of that play. It's going to see it right there.
Ooh.
Bucky got thrown out of the game for a similar play against Greg Paulus.
Then we got a dead ball, elbow technical foul on 12 White.
So it's going to be, I believe,
we'll sort this all out.
It's a dead ball technical foul on Kyle Singler for that elbow. Here it is again. Behind. Thomas came out of nowhere. Hansbro, jump hook. Yes.
See, that's what he needs to do. That's nice recognition because he saw there was no double team.
Well, Danny Green picked up his dribble, almost got into trouble. This is Lawson. Right down Main Street.
Well, he got the switch and McClure got exposed on that play. Lawson. Very aggressive looking for his offense.
Back to four. Here's the steal. Ellington. 2-point game.
Those are the plays in North Carolina.
Bunches. You know, Tyler Hansbro's two fouls in the first half came within 11 seconds of each other. See the Women of the World scoreboard. We'll update you on not only the ACC games, SEC games, all across the country. Lost in the alley-oop to Hansbro.
A well-conceived play coming out of the timeout. Just lost.
Step back jumper. Yes. How about that?
It looked like Larry Bird on that play, not letting the clock affect.
Mike, a lot of people thought that Carolina would come in here and dominate because of their inside game, and there's the offensive foul on Greg Paulus.
Now, on the one hand, Hansbro really exposed his teammate because he didn't call the screen out, but he stepped up and atones for it. There's the screen right there that takes Frazier's head off, and then you can see Hansbro, we talked about it, he's a very good perimeter defender.
Thomas and Thompson really battling. This is Frazier for three. Draws the back of the iron. Thompson comes up with it. Drew penetrates. Ellington for three. He's got 11 points.
Yeah, maybe that's the shot that gets him into some sort of rhythm that struggled from the floor up to that point. For a great shooter, it doesn't take much.
Henderson steps back beyond the arc. Halfway down, comes back out.
Especially in this first 8 minutes or so of the second half, Duke settling for the jump shot a little too easily.
Carolina gets it back. Drew falls. Frazier left alone underneath to Davis. He banks it in.
Yeah, a nice under control move, and Bobby Frazier consistently grades out as one of their better defenders from North Carolina.
Lawson banks it in.
Yeah, he's also started to look more aggressive.
Really has on Hansbro in a hurry because he was going to take that jumper. Thompson on Singler. He's going to take him to the hoop and score.
Yeah, again, no double-team help coming for Singler right there, and Thompson's starter.
3-point game. That'll bring the crowd back into it. The crazies are bouncing again. Lawson running one-handed. How about that?
Well, he's been impressive off the dribble in the second half. I think it makes it tough to go both ways, Tim, right and left.
Lawson gets a hand on it, comes up with it. He's going to race Paulus to the bucket. With body control.
And Paulus made that, or Lawson made that play too, because.
But UNC has been strong here in the second half. If you want to see highlights of today's game,
pushes its lead back up to 9 with 6:41 to play.
North Carolina continuing to bang inside and use the free throw line with advantage now, plus 10 there.
Shire fell down. The pass was intended for him. Smith saw him coming. Shot clock has not come into play very often for Carolina tonight, but it's down to 10 now. Lawson looks at it, recognizes it. Kicks it out to Hansbrough with 4 on the shot clock. He'll have to fire from long range and hits it.
That's a killer shot right there.
Oh, my.
You play defense for 33 seconds, and then the other team's center steps out, knocks down a 3, and breaks your heart.
83-71, Carolina's largest lead. Knocked away again. Tar Heels starting to widen the gap. Lawson with the rebound. Shire and Lawson get tied up. No hurry now for Carolina. With this lead, they can melt the clock, shorten the game. Shot clock down to 12. And last touch by Duke, a new shot clock for the Tar Heels.
Well, it's been a football-like one.
4:35 to play. Henderson's got to come to life. He falls. Floor's been slippery. He goes down, and they lose it out of bounds. 14 turnovers.
Well, and he's the certainly has shown up for the Blue Devils behind the arc.
Well, Hansbrough looked, almost pulled the trigger.
Now he's got a mismatch against Nolan Smith inside.
Lawson with a great first step. Makes the bucket. He'll go to the line for one more.
And Lawson had a mismatch out front, too. When they got the switch right there, he just took Singler off the bounce.
Ty Lawson with 16 second half points. How about this crossover? The bucket and the foul.
Shot, and Duke played very good defense, and this was with 2 seconds to go on the shot clock. You don't expect a result like that from Tyler Hansbrough, but maybe you should, as a guy who is a certain player of the year. They have not needed it this evening.
And out to Lawson. Drive home safely, everybody. This one's in the bank.
100 points in this building. That is not easy to do.
Singler off balance, fouled by Tyler Hansbrough. Mike, your final thoughts?
Well, Isaiah, it's just a very dominant offensive performance by North Carolina, and they also played well defensively in the second half.
Great second half by Ty Lawson for Carolina. 25 points for the game. You've been watching exclusive coverage of ACC basketball on Raycom Sports. For Mike Jaminski, I'm Tim Brandt saying so long from Cameron Indoor Stadium in Durham, North Carolina. Good night, everybody.
Here he goes again. Sizing up Ellington. The last lead Miami had, it was 26-24. The crossover to the hole. Rejected by Danny Green. A great block by Green. And a whistle on Thomas as Hansbrough goes into the photographers. On the night, he came in with 23. North Carolina led by as many as 14. Lawson goes down as he hits the 3. Goes to 4.
That is the 13th three-point field goal attempt of the second half for North Carolina. That's where they've been limited.
Working off the pick, Adrian Thomas answers with a 3. And we're back to a one-point North Carolina advantage.
It's a great job by Miami to keep the pressure on North Carolina.
Ellington has it poked away. Plenty of time on the shot clock. Lawson, a deep 3. And he's got another one. Great job by Ty Lawson and Roy Williams getting excited. And the lead is 4, 2:40 to play.
Lawson hadn't been able to drive the ball to the basket, but he's knocked down a couple of 3s.
Thomas hands it off to Asbury. McClinton underneath, running the baseline, pops out. Lawson lost him. McClinton, oh my! Are you kidding me? McClinton with 33. Now, they get it to him.
But he's got to be down on the block.
Eight to shoot. Ellington looks up. The three. Rebound. Graham again. Miami with 143 with a chance to take the lead, and we've got a timeout.
They're in the zone defense, controlling Tyler Hansbrough on the inside, limiting North Carolina to three-point shots, has really held the score down.
And now James Dews will handle the basketball. And, of course, they get it to McClinton, guarded by Frazier. Hammered as he goes inside. Grant had point-blank range and couldn't finish it.
McClinton drives the ball to the basket. That was really conceptualized very well. Drew all the defenders. Graham just couldn't knock it home.
They leave Ellington open for a second. He doesn't pull the trigger.
See, McClinton is in there behind Hansbrough. You have to throw Hansbrough the ball. Now Graham switches out on him. I just don't think the North Carolina Tar Heels have been looking inside enough for Tyler Hansbrough.
1 minute left. Seven on the shot clock. Lawson to Ellington. Nice crossover, leans inside. Jimmy Graham does a nice job holding his ground. Asbury almost walked with it. That's going to be an offensive foul as Tyler Hansbrough. Nice job defensively.
This is your 6'9 star inside player who sprints down the court and against a perimeter guy establishes his defensive position and is able to draw the charge.
And we've got a timeout.
Graham switches back.
Well, even a two-pointer by North Carolina would still make it a three-point game. And the way Miami's been hitting the three, that's not out of the realm of possibility of them coming down and tying this thing up.
About an eight-second difference between the shot clock and the game clock.
And Roy Williams will burn one of his remaining timeouts. They're trying to get their second win over the Tar Heels.
And now with Miami coming out playing man-to-man, it's going to be hard to stand back there in that zone down 1 point. So Miami goes to the man-to-man.
Shot clock at five. Lawson has the ball, the long three. Nothing but the bottom of the net.
How big has he been? Wow.
This is a guy that Roy Williams said he is as sick as a dog at halftime. Made.
And they've all been from behind the arc. This is just a situation, not very much of a screen right there, but enough to give Lawson some. See, that's the thing with Lawson. You have to play him to drive to the basket. And as I say, if he's going to make threes, he's impossible to guard.
Well, McClinton just wants to get the two with 4.6 left, and Frank Haith's going to burn a timeout. He tried to cut through the defense's court.
Now, obviously, the first option is to steal the ball.
Green fakes the long pass to Frazier. Gets it into Ellington, who is going to be fouled by Thomas on the play. And again, Tyler Hansbrough takes a wicked.
Well, and it's been the three-point shot for Lawson. Everybody's so worried about him driving the ball to the basket, you tend to give him some room, and you just simply can't give him room. And obviously he's excited by that, and he should be, but on that basket.
Frazier to trigger it inbound. Lawson's got it, and he's going to be fouled.
Timeout left. So if Lawson misses, it's going to be a challenge to get the ball up the court fast enough, but
that's a move. But if he makes this,
the clock starts as soon as somebody touches the ball. If he misses, and here he makes it, it's a four-point lead. Roy Williams stops the game by making a substitute, so North Carolina can set the defense. All you have to do here now, if you're the Tar Heels, is not commit a foul.
Lawson, the last 11 North Carolina points, and that's going to do it. A valiant effort by Miami, but the poise of North Carolina stands tall tonight. Ty Lawson coming up big in the ballgame, 21 points, 15 for Ellington. And Miami will lose this contest 69-65. We'll be back.
The Georgia Tech Yellow Jackets in an ACC battle. And the standings in the conference, North Carolina with the top spot,
10 wins in conference play. Different story.
That you don't normally hit. Guys hitting shots they don't normally hit.
Yeah, but you also have to get those shots, Gus. And by that, I mean not turning the basketball over.
Here we go to the basket. Drew up and in.
And what's impressive about North Carolina now, they're doing this.
Good job staying right in his hip pocket. In and out dribble. Baseline, Tyler Zeller. Got it up. Oh, rims out. Lawson. New shot clock. Green rising. And good.
Effort plays there, Gus. Coming up with the loose ball again leads to a big-time three by Danny Green. The perimeter.
27 to 25. He has six. Hansbrough again. Short that time. Picks up his own rebound. Working hard and one. Big boy school inside for Tyler Hansbrough. Hansbrough. Not afraid of contact as well. On our throat in transition. Baseline, Lawson. Now Frazier right open. Got it.
It's funny, you see the difference really between Ty Lawson and Mo Miller. That four rises, can you remain poised? And that's been a problem for Georgia Tech.
Frazier shows it. Oh, finger roll. And Lawson almost came up with the steal. Georgia Tech. How about Bobby Frazier curling down the lane? Nice little fake and bucket. Quick shots being taken by Georgia Tech. They've lost that rhythm.
Oh.
And Davis finishing strong.
Davis with a beautiful finish, but how about the feed from Larry Drew, the second? Beautiful bounce pass into the post. Again, rhythm, right in the rhythm. It allows Davis to catch, turn, and finish with the contact. Beautiful delivery there in transition. In the entire country in free throw shooting, therefore they don't tend to get there very often.
Only two attempts in the first half. Hansbrough on the baseline. He had 18 points in the first half. Takes the jump shot, and now he has 20.
I cannot tell you how difficult a shot
on the floor. And Clinch has had a very nice game for Georgia Tech. Green, though, answering with a three.
See, that, making all these threes for Danny Green now.
Cool nature.
And what I love about him is he's always in attack mode, whether he has the basketball or not. If he doesn't have it, he seeks position to where it forces you to find him. And that's one of the things I love about him. He's such an efficient and effective.
Yellow Jackets, 56 to 35, Carolina. Here in the second half, ball knocked away and stolen again by Thompson. Thompson to the basket. Timeout, Georgia Tech. The turnovers mounting now. Seven turnovers, and this time it's Deion Thompson with terrific anticipation. Gets down the floor and to the basket. And Carolina takes a 64 to 41 lead. Loose ball, another steal, Lawson. Green in transition, nicely done.
And they are just lethal in the open floor in terms of their fast break.
66-41. Clinch, deep jump shot. Hansbrough with a rebound. Hansbrough with nine rebounds. Lawson deals it again. Lawson getting everybody involved. Green with the steal, the lean, and hits.
What a clinic. Unbelievable performance, and really you can feel the frustration for Paul Hewitt to succumb. And don't worry about the score if you're Georgia Tech. You're playing for the rest of your season.
Frazier to the basket. Frazier has had a nice game off the bench, 7 points. He averages two per game. And Carolina takes a 72 to 46 lead. Hansbrough got a hand on it. Loose ball picked up. Drew in the front court. Ellington, Hansbrough, power dribble, jam.
I forgot to mention, Gus, that North Carolina is playing like the game is close, too. The intensity
right.
Is not relented here in the second half. And that's the difference between just being a basketball talent and being a basketball player.
Zeller jump up.
Case in point, with Ty Lawson understanding early offense, open man on the post.
Nice anticipation for Bobby as he goes the length of the floor for the bucket.
And that's what Coach Williams, he coaches, you don't play the score. You play the possession. Forget what the score says. You go out there and compete every possession you're on the floor throughout the course of this game, and it's always an advantage when you can have a guy go get you 23. And they finally get to the 100-point mark there. But when you can have a guy get you 23 and you don't.
Welcome to Duke and North Carolina. The team's just taking the floor. Jim Nance, Clark Kellogg here at the Dean Dome, and Roy Williams sends out seven to start the game. Obviously, this is a symbolic gesture as he put all the seniors on the floor to come out and address the opening tip. Then Moody and Wooten and Tanner all sit, and now we're about to get underway. Ty Lawson is a go, folks.
So excited about trying to give a good show in your last performance before the home fans that you tend to press a little bit.
A Duke turnover, which has been a rarity these days. The last four games, single. Henderson is going to challenge Frazier. Ball comes out, and it lands in the hands of Thompson. Head ahead to Ellington. Sees teammate underneath. It's Lawson, and he draws the foul. Ellington runs it down.
I tell you what, Lawson doesn't look too bad in these first 3 minutes.
Shear, who's been on a roll lately. Singler, and it's going the other way. Hansbrough drew it. Singler's first.
Already Duke with three turnovers, and you missed that time by North Carolina. Aggressive, active man-to-man.
Duke has turned it over its last three possessions. Here's Lawson to Green, and Carolina with six unanswered.
With that play by Elliott Williams to aggressively attack the rim and then retrieve his own miss and take his time to find the open singler.
Hansbrough knocks down a three. His eighth three of the season. Not something we saw really any of his first 3 years. Now showing he can shoot it from the outside. 8 of 17 on the season. Charge. The first time he got the call, the second time he didn't. Now what happened under here?
That's Ed Davis going for the throwdown. And
oh.
Zubek was in the wrong place at the wrong time. Nothing intentional or malicious there. It was Zubek.
The Blue Devils have won five straight. They're on a hot streak here late in the year. Green will put it up from the wing. Follow up Ellington. Came flying through the lane, perfectly timed. Switch off, Lawson gives it up to the freshman, Ed Davis.
That's what Ty Lawson can really do to a defense, break the nice pass.
Hansbrough set down for about 3 minutes. Now he's reinserted along with Bobby Frazier. Davis.
Boy, this young fella has some kind of promise, Jim. Excellent hands, tremendous range, and a feathery touch there on that nice little six-footer.
Gives him 6 points, 7 rebounds. A game off the bench. McClure has come in for Duke. Sets a screen on Lawson. Gets it open for Singler. Hansbrough plucks it. Hansbrough with McClure trying to defend. Puts up the shot. Fought his way for it. Carolina by four.
Yeah, he just out-muscled the smaller McClure.
To the corner. Shire hits a three.
Those are the kinds of shots that Duke wants to get in its offense.
Ellington squeezes it up and in. Ellington with the basket.
can see here, Jim, Duke not interested in playing a racehorse game. They want to run selectively and make it more of a half-court game. In order for that to be effective, those kinds of shots are going to have to fall with the regularity today.
Hansbrough's already hit 1-3. Make it 2. And his final home game. Tyler Hansbrough hitting a couple of threes in the first 9.5 minutes. Well, look who's here. Michael Jordan being introduced. Both teams shooting over 50. Hansbrough. Here's Drew.
Nice job by Elliott Williams here, keeping Drew in front.
To the corner, feeds Frazier. 3. Yes. Knocks down a 3 in his final home game. 7 different players have already scored for North Carolina. Bro, showing a little outside game here, Clark.
Splashing a couple of threes. Stepping out, undefended. Take that. Double time. And I mean, he stroked them pure. Nothing but net on both of those trips from behind the three-point arc.
The freshman from Memphis puts Duke back ahead by 1. And bank shot by Thompson. Two years ago against Duke, Tyler Hansbrough got hit in the nose by Henderson. Carolina went on to win that game 86-72. What a scene it was. It promises to be today.
Thompson sat down in his stance and made it really difficult for Singler to get anything good on that drive. Singler matched up on Hansbrough now.
Now it's Ellington. Tipped up and in. Deion Thompson.
Was it Thompson or Hansbrough? You're right.
They gave it to Thompson. And the lead is 1 for Duke.
Well, I won't question you anymore.
No, you.
The pace of your cuts and your drives. And you saw Shire do it that time.
Shire with 11 points. Ellington fade away. Knocks this one down.
You know, on offense, you want to mix speeds, Jim. You don't always want to go really fast. There's off balance.
Traveling call against Thomas. And now Carolina can take the last shot and a chance to take the lead into the locker room. McClure comes in for defensive purposes for Duke. Just a moment. Time by 1. The Thompson. Ellington trying to get past Shire and wow. Able to maneuver the body to get the shot off cleanly somehow. That's Henderson splits the defenders. Long rebound, Hansbrough. His 4th rebound. Go with his 10 points. And a Green, yes, and Carolina is back in front. Crowd to its feet. Singler try to quiet him here. Rolls out. Lawson. His first basket of the game. And timeout, Duke. A 7-point run by North Carolina.
Position and ability to compete and win. Well, he gets it done at both ends.
There's Davis. And it's going to go against Hansbrough, push it off. Second on Tyler.
Roy Williams thought Gerald Henderson was guilty of grabbing Hansbrough. Let's take a look. Weak side. He did have that left arm out right in the chest of Hansbrough. But I think that's a case of the bigger guy being.
About senior day, and there was quite an emotional ceremony here before the game. And speeches are coming after the game when Hansbrough was introduced. Roy Williams the first to tell you that he's a sap at things like this. Mother Tammy, Father Gene, all kinds of family in town, including
one time off a defensive rebound. Otherwise, they've wanted to control the pace by executing in the half court.
Zubek back on the floor. Thompson over him. Hits the jumper.
That's a nice move there. Anytime you catch it in the post, Jim, I don't think you should ever.
That's Ellington. Over the outstretched arm of McClure. Now it's Singler. Bounces twice, right back to him. Singler short, tipped out to Lawson. Carolina's got the rhythm. Lawson puts it up and he's heading to the line. Taken over, now the lead by five. Carolina did this at Cameron in the second half.
Tough shot here by Wayne Ellington and Danny Green. Pull up three, splash. Lawson, pull up 15-footer, mark it up. And Carolina now starting to rev it up because he'd be shot hungry.
Shire comes out with it. Singler again, and he's going to call for the charge. That's Frazier who drew it.
Singler looking to be aggressive here. Actually a 4-on-2. And boy, I tell you, let's look at it again. Another angle. I thought Frazier got there in pretty good shape. I don't like to see that call. I like to give the benefit of the doubt to the offensive player there. As a matter of fact, I know this is college, but it's 9 out of 10 cases. And I'd like to see the same be applied in the college game.
Ellington drives in for two. Hansbrough's back on the floor. That charge call gets chalked up as Duke's first turnover of the second half.
And Mike Krzyzewski still voicing his displeasure with Jamie Lucky about that call.
Now it's Williams spinning. Hansbrough to Lawson. And a push off on Williams. His third. And it's raucous here in Chapel Hill. As it was back in 2004 when the on CBS already, home of the NCAA basketball championship, the Missouri Valley Final. You saw it with Northern Iowa winning and Coach K.
Yeah, he and Jamie Lucky getting to know each other just a little bit there.
Earlier today on CBS, Alabama, Tennessee.
There you see the free throw numbers. Carolina leaving a lot of points at the line.
Singler, long rebound, Lawson. They feed it to Hansbrough. Turnaround, yes. Tyler Hansbrough. His first field goal since 10:38 was on the clock in the first half. Over. What will they do with the two? Lob it, Hansbrough. Oh, and a foul's going to be called. Singler trying to tap it away. And it's going to be a 1-on-1. Third foul on Singler.
Let's take a look here.
There he is. He bumped him with the lower body and actually got his hand, his arm tangled up just a.
They're double checking we here to see if, in fact, if it was an elbow, a flagrant foul. Thompson picks up his second. Thompson ball comes out and it's Green out of the pack. Pull up three on the run. They're going to call it a two. It's a two, not a three. And Michael Jordan applauds.
He's at the foul line, missing free throws. But you get the sense if Carolina could push the lead to double digits, that might be enough to get to the winner's circle.
Oh, that's Hansbrough. That's his shot. And he's now up to 14 on the game.
Was him to miss that one-handed dunk attempt.
Henderson's first basket since 6 minutes remained in the first half. They're going to count the basket. Lawson, Thompson, and the heels. Look at this.
Big time play right here by Deion Thompson. Able to just beat the double team as Lance Thomas gets there with his arm instead of his body.
Four fouls. Thompson for the three-point play, and it's a five-point North Carolina lead. Thompson has 14.
Exactly what he had in the first meeting, Jim.
Here's Singler back in and long with the three. Lawson up ahead. Ellington taking it to the hole, and Carolina is back up by the largest margin of the game, matching their largest lead of seven.
I think it's going to be Shire.
Takes the long three. Got it from the floor. Down to two. Huge shot by Shire. Lawson, meanwhile, kicks it out. Green from the wing with a three. Answers right back. What a moment. Just when Duke got within two, Green brings it back to five. Green. Now Lawson. He'll take it in, and he's going to the line for a three-point play. Lawson, questionable coming in. No question now after this move.
He is so quick and explosive and so strong when he gets into that paint. That can just go through the contact of Shire. But that explosiveness is what makes him so.
He wants to take a little time out here. Set things up with 103 defensively. We'll come back with Lawson shooting one. And now for a chance to put Carolina up by seven. And again, that's been the ceiling on the lead today. They've been here at this juncture a number of times, but it's seven with only 103 remaining. They bring in Frazier.
Duke doesn't have to have a three here. They need something good, something quick.
And that's Frazier reaching in, tie-up situation, an arrow to the Tar Heels. Roy Williams takes the timeout, puts Frazier into the game, out of it, and Frazier comes in and makes the stop and gets the ball back for the Tar Heels. Singler has to put it up. Hansbrough has another rebound. And now the seniors on this North Carolina team can savor the final seconds of their home career, including Hansbrough, who will go to the line.
Strong, typical Tyler Hansbrough type effort.
His family. North Carolina takes over in the second half. And the Tar Heels are the ACC champions for 2009. Here's the lineup tonight.
Sky 5 over the Dean Smith Center in Chapel Hill. Thousands just witnessed a battle for Tobacco Road bragging rights and first place in the ACC. Good afternoon.
Come on out, fellas. Come on out. Hey. Thank y'all. Well, thank you.
From Poplar Bluff, Missouri, number 50, senior Tyler Hansbrough.
Thank you. It's kind of hard to put in words what my experience at Carolina has been like. It's been some of the best, it's been the best 4 years of my life. It's because of everybody right there. It's because of I'm going to start off with Coach Williams. When Coach was recruiting me, he said, son, I'll never lie to you. And that's something that he's done for 4 years. And I really appreciate that. He never tells you what you want to hear. He always tells you what you need to hear. My two brothers, I thank you, Greg, for everything you taught me, man. And Ben, you know, those rough times we had in the backyard, you know, it's always been fun. You know, without you two, I wouldn't be in the position I am. And my dad, I want to say,
come on back inside the Georgia Dome. We're all set for game one here this afternoon. Virginia Tech and North Carolina that just played March 4th. Carolina won that one barely.
To take that ball right into him. Justin Watts in the game. He's only played 62 minutes all year. There's Frazier with a three. That'll help.
Bobby Frazier. He was 3-for-4 beyond the arc at Duke, but 0-for-13 on the road. Boy, Delaney almost picked Frazier's pocket.
Again, you're not worried about Frazier driving it past you to the basket.
Hunkett buries a three. Trip. A little bit of a drop for the Hokies.
Well, Ellington nice inside left outside.
Ellington buries the three.
He thought he missed it. He was chasing down the rebound. The ball went in the basket. Nice inside outside work by North Carolina.
Carolina's never led, but we've had three ties, including this one.
It's a bit of an offensively challenged team out there at the moment for Virginia Tech. Delaney does a nice job to take charge.
Ellington left alone. Splash. Uh-oh.
That's not good news for Virginia Tech if Ellington is going to get hot from outside.
59% free throw shooter. But JT gets the roll there. And that's a one-point Tech lead. Shot clock is off. Behind his back. Underneath. How about that? Drive, draw, and dish. Oh, is that a special first half? Zeller out front to Drew. Inside to Hansbrough. You knew that was coming. Hansbrough again.
Oh, wow! How in the world did he make that shot? They need
to give him the ball.
Drew drives and can't score. Hansbro still has it. Ball's loose. Zeller comes up with it. Green for three.
Oh, what a powerful man. Move by Zeller.
And Allen couldn't go after him with the
no, that's right.
J.T. Thompson now matched up against Hansbro.
Here's Hansbro, backs in. Thompson with a follow.
See, Hansbro draws such attention even when he misses. Thompson does a great job getting in position of Thompson.
Game is in the hands of Malcolm Delaney, and I think if you're Virginia Tech, you're pretty comfortable with that.
Delaney's three, draws iron. Carolina with a chance to take the lead. Hansbro wants it, he gets it, he's fouled.
But he's upset that he missed that shot. It's not often he goes just against one guy inside.
Has taken 219 free throws this year. That's sweet.
They can afford to be very, very aggressive down the stretch.
Makes them both. Carolina leads by one. 73 seconds to play. Ty Lawson saying, reach deep. Carolina fans on their feet. Seconds to play. Masayo backs in. Here, jumper is short. Gets his own rebound. The putback.
Oh,
yes,
what a play!
Five on the game clock, 29 on the shot clock. This is Ellington. You know where they're going. There he is. And Hansbro answers.
There's about 6/10 of a second difference between the shot clock and the game clock. Actually, 2/10 of a second.
Back through the window of time, just like last year. Here we go. There's the 6, 5 seconds left. Shot off balance. Where's the big guy? There he is with a jumper and the winner. And the player of the year doing his crab dance after the big shot. How about that celebration? And the Tar Heels won it by 2.
Foul. And get another opportunity.
Here's Masayo, no hold. They double him. Dangerous pass.
There's a foul on Ellington, but keep in mind, that's a non-shooting foul. That's a great play by Ellington. North Carolina can afford to be very aggressive in those situations. That's only the 4th team foul, so no shots are involved here. Ellington going for the steal. You can't run through the offensive player.
Seth,
you can make it. You know, you got to look for Masayo or Delaney to take the shot in this situation.
Shot clock is off. Frazier on Delaney. And the foul on Hansbro. So there's
no,
one more.
No problem. They got North Carolina can be aggressive trying to not deny the ball inbounds.
Delaney. Dangerous. Jump ball, possession arrow belongs to Carolina.
Seth Greenberg's got to be very careful.
Oh, my.
Tim, I think the problem
he wanted
on that
the foul.
Play, this pass was not intended for Thompson. Thompson, I think, picked it off. I believe they were trying to throw the ball back to Dorenzo Hudson. JT Thompson actually picked it off. Seth Greenberg obviously upset with the call.
He wanted a foul. He thinks his guy was mugged.
It's very interesting. Right before that play, Delaney drove into the lane and tried to pass it back, but I do not.
Oh, I'm not saying. I just said you hate to see that. You've watched this thing all afternoon. And the players were at such a high level. And that'll be it for Allen, so he's disqualified. Picked at the line today, 8 for 8.
2-point differential.
Now Roy Williams calls a timeout. You might say, well, why did he call to go before we get to the Syracuse-UConn game?
Oh, no, that's in a class of its own. Here's Masayo. Three ball. Carolina wins it and advances.
To win this game. And for the second year in a row to come this close and not be able to do it is really, has got to be very disappointing.
And exhilarating for the guys in white. Doesn't get any better than this, folks. We've got interviews. We'll talk with the players, the participants. We come back. Stay with us. Carolina wins and advances. Oh, my.
Of the action in Greensboro, South Region action, number 8 LSU, top seed in the South, North Carolina. Let's send you there now.
Big news here, just minutes ago, Roy Williams out on the floor with Ty Lawson, who's missed the last three games, talks to his star point guard, ACC Player of the Year, and nods his head, yes. He alerts the scorer's table. Insert Hansbro did not miss the other night, misses two straight.
Yeah, he had made 34 of his last 36 from the line before that jump.
But it sets up a three by Ellington. Well, it all worked out for the Tar Heels, plus one.
Yeah, right.
Garrett Temple, more minutes than anyone.
And he ranks in the top 10 in assists, steals, and blocked shots. How about that for a guard?
Yep. Well, there's Davis with the turnaround. We're talking about the ACC's play. I don't get a thought on that from you, but one of the losses we should add was actually Maryland losing today. So they weren't all first round losses, but the Terrapins got pretty easily handled today by Memphis. What about the ACC? Surprise you?
A little bit, but again, the matchups dictate who advances and who doesn't, Jim. It's not about conferences, it's about teams. And those teams play tough opponents in the first round of the tournament.
Frazier with the steal. Ellington gives it up. Green, who waits and scores. Frazier, Ellington, Green.
Good timeout here by Trent Johnson. He does not want Carolina to get going and to fuel this pro Tar Heels crowd.
Against a team that has Final Four experience with two starters and a team that just blitzed through the SEC, a conference that has produced champions. And here is Ellington reading it and going in uncontested. That's twice now they have been able to pick off the pass just past midcourt. Leading the baskets.
Well, they had 11 steals the other night against Radford, and here they are trapping Garrett Temple, Ty Lawson right in the middle of it. You don't want to pick up your dribble along the sideline.
Who retains it?
Yeah, you can tell Ty Lawson is pain. Yeah, he's hurting. He's
goodness.
He's in agony.
He is in considerable pain.
He can shoot the deep three. Whether he's open or challenged, he can get the mid-range shot off the dribble, and he can take you right to the rim off the dribble. And he's 6'4", 205 pounds, so he's strong enough to finish with contact.
That's Hansbro. That is vintage Tyler Hansbro, who on Thursday, center, 6'11", hit some shots from the outside on Thursday. He does so again, his first outside shot. Ellington, this is a three on the way. And Hansbro comes over and says, I'll take it. Careful, this is going to be on Mitchell. And that's two now. That's an issue for the Tigers. Now let you back in front by one. Feed it down to Deion Thompson. His turnaround.
That's his shot.
Yep.
That's his shot. He loved that turnaround over the right shoulder.
Usually banks it home. This time went straight net and hits it. Carolina back on top. Fade away Temple. Four rebounds now for Hansbro. Lawson lost the handle. Feeds it over Hansbro. And there's an assist for Lawson. Hansbro hits the jumper. Tyler has eight.
And 5-9, not allow North Carolina to get to a double-digit cushion. And so far, his team has been able to do that. Watch out now.
What a tough shot. He had Garrett Temple on him, who's a great defender. And Ellington's had just a brilliant stretch here. Double figures in 21 straight games, and he's already got 9 in this one.
Ball movement, spacing. Try to get it in the hands of your playmakers with an opportunity to make a shot.
Thornton splits. Tries to go back to Mitchell. Hansbrough saw it coming. Up ahead, Lawson. Lawson inside. He's got his first points in his return. And North Carolina has its largest lead.
And then he just got whistled for the foul here. Kind of a 5- and 10-cent foul. But you're right, Jim. Good maneuverability. He showed you the burst of speed and had to come to a stop and change direction. Little flip shot inside.
He's got 10 of the Tigers, 26. That is Ellington getting the roll. He's got another double-figure game. North Carolina leading it here, 33-26. That's Hansbrough reaching around and making the theft up ahead, Green, and that's a foul as well. Basket counts. Chris Johnson got a piece of him. Carolina on a roll. It's largest lead of the game. They can make it 10 with the free throw after the break. Suddenly a one-point game. And Lawson hits his first jumper of the day. Ty Lawson had made only 1 of 5 in the first half for 2 points. Carolina's double-digit lead is down to 1. There is another block shot, 3rd of the half, up ahead for the lead. Thornton lays it in, and LSU has made it back. Timeout, North Carolina. What an explosive beginning to the second half. LSU in front. Carolina 1 of 6 now coming out of the locker room. They lob it for Johnson, and LSU on 7 straight trips, and the LSU contingent getting cheered on by the Duke fans.
Confident about being patient and playing through their 2 top scorers, Mitchell and Thornton.
Oh, what a block by Davis. Again, it's Davis. Back-to-back blocks, but they both return to the Tigers, who put up the 3, and it's Bo Spencer. The sophomore, so cool, hits another 3 in this half, and LSU now by 3. Clean blocks by Davis.
He was just able to get a bead on both of those. He's a weak-eyed defender in that situation. He's a 41% three-point field goal shooter, Jim, and you said it. He is absolutely unflappable.
Ellington is too at the other end. Story of that trip.
Yep, a fortuitous bounce.
Here's Marcus Thornton with Frazier reaching in and stealing. Up ahead, Lawson. Lawson with 8 in the half, 10 on the game.
That's why he's the ACC POY. He's showing you exactly why he won that award this year. His team needs him to make big plays and shots, and he's doing it here in the second half.
22-11 advantage this half. Thanks in large part to this guy, Tasman Mitchell, who swings it over to Temple for the open 3. And now it's a 5-point lead for the number 8 seed. Ellington gives it up. Perfect pass this time to Davis.
North Carolina would love to try to speed this pace up, but to do that, they're going to have to defend and defensive rebound, and they're going to have to be able to guard Tasman Mitchell effectively one-on-one.
That was careless and well played by Ellington, who leans in to trim it to 1.
Boy, and he got bumped, too, there. The officials elected not to make a call. Roy Williams wondering, how could he not be shooting a foul shot? And I'm right with you, Roy.
Yep.
A lot of contact there as Ellington made a terrific play after the steal.
Spencer on the wing.
short. Missed his last two from out there after making a couple. Lawson to Fraser. Give it up, Ellington. That is a three. And that puts North Carolina back ahead. They had been down five. Seven unanswered by the Tar Heels. This is the guy they want shooting it. Thornton gets the three at the other end to grab the lead back for Louisiana State University. Lawson penetrating, cutting through, his best move of the night.
Well, you can see the adrenaline picking up. He jammed that toe again as he came back limping.
Yep.
But the adrenaline is going to... Yeah, terrific move here. He's got such strength and quickness and explodes through defenders. But on the land, I think he jams that toe again. There you see the slight grimace.
We have the third foul here on Tyler Hansbro. America's Most Watched Network.
You got to try to get it to Hansbro if you're North Carolina to put some pressure on Chris Johnson.
Ellington Temple was all over him. I mean, defending him as well as he could without touching him. But Ellington has 21 on the game, 10 and a half. Deion Thompson, perhaps they'll try to get him to that timeout. It'll be taken under eight on the first whistle. Thornton, they had to have it. It was a big run going by the Tar Heels at 12-3. Until Marcus Thornton knocks it down, giving him 19 on the game, 12 and a half. Back to one. Carolina on top. Ellington again. Deion Thompson anticipates. Marcus Thornton, that ties it. And he is starting to simmer.
Well, we talked about it at halftime.
Downs goes back to North Carolina. Ty Lawson's coming back in. He's having a huge second half.
As he's done countless times this season. Hurt you in a number of ways. Look at the strength and the explosiveness off the dribble. He's really good at keeping that dribble low. So to maintain contact as Thornton works through a number of screens. Good job there by Danny Green to close out.
Asmund Mitchell, a freshman on his back. And that is a turnover again. Lawson showing that speed, puts it up with spin. Oh my goodness, it was rolling off the rim.
How about this young man tonight? You know he's not 100%. He hasn't played in 2 weeks, but it's game time. And he gets right through defenders, and that's the way you spin it in.
Third foul on Marcus Thornton. Lawson has 12 and a half.
Do if he's not going to make a quick move, get rid of it quickly.
Garrett Temple, that's wide. And it's Ed Davis giving him some valuable time off the bench today.
He's done that all year long, Jim.
Lawson, not this time. Tipped out by Thornton, should have just grabbed the rebound. Now it's Green, steps over for the three from the wing, it's short. Green gets to load it up again. Well, Quentin Thornton had a couple of attempts at some rebounds down there, but Carolina fought just a little harder for the rebound, and Danny Green makes the lead seven.
Around, you can end up accidentally committing a foul.
Lawson, oh, what a move. And a shot to pay it off.
That's why he's the best point guard in the country, because he understands when he needs to score, when he needs to get other people involved.
Well, the rust was there in the first half, plus the re-aggravation, but he came back. That shot blocked by Ellington, and he'll grab it before it goes out. But it's a different Lawson here in the second half. What it was at halftime, back to nine. With the nine unanswered here by the Heels.
With the foul situation, what it is,
You would expect North Carolina to look to attack through Lawson or post up Hansbrough.
Turnaround, Hansbrough hits the shot. His first field goal since about 4 minutes remained in the first half. On an 11-point run, fueled by the ACC Player of the Year, Ty Lawson. Missed five straight shots, had gone 4 minutes. Ellington zooms past Martin and hits another floater, now with 23.
Wow. Well, I tell you, between he and Lawson, they have been absolutely scintillating here in this second half. Good rotation by Lawson. He got a hand on it.
Yeah, he forced it. Will he take it all the way? Yes. And he'll head to the line. That's going to be against Marcus Thornton. Little five-on-five contact.
Get a score here.
13-point lead, 2:20 to play.
Yeah, and you've still got plenty of fouls to give, already over the limits. I think now, yeah, Roy Williams wants a 20-second timeout. He was trying to get it, although Trent Johnson may have gotten it. And I think he might sit Ty Lawson when we come back.
Here's in the second half, but the Tar Heels behind Lawson, just too much. Let's go back to Greg Gumbel.
Meanwhile, time for the second tip of the night in Memphis, Gonzaga, Carolina. Let's take you there live. Jim Nance and Clark Kellogg.
By Gonzaga, the only loss in that 21-game stretch to Memphis.
Hansbrough jumper and Hansbrough on net.
Teams take pretty good care of the basketball. They're very efficient and explosive on offense.
It's Lawson. Puts up the three and knocks it down. That scrutinized sprained big toe on the right foot that kept them out of three games. Kept them out of the first round game against Radford. Here's Day. Ball stripped out. Goes middle. Thompson.
That's back-to-back turnovers.
Nice.
Bolden likes this shot. Lawson looking for a seam. Bounce pass it to Green. Perfectly placed by Lawson.
This guy does everything for Gonzaga. He's strong, he's physical, he's smart, he's tough. Threw it away that time, but typically stuffs the stat sheet in a positive way every game.
That's now three turnovers on Gonzaga and Danny Green. Good on the three. Well, yeah, Tony Crocker really kind of find himself here in the first game, and he had been missing in action from outside. And Austin Day matches at the other end. Well, Carolina's had some similar recent difficulties by Danny Green from the outside. He hits his first long range shot. Austin Day, though, comes right back down and puts a three up for the Bulldogs.
Tough matchup here now, and Day backing off of Lawson. See, he had to respect his ability to drive him.
Well, he scored, what, 6 points, two assists, and a steal so far.
Yeah, he's eased nicely into this game. Got the pilfer right there. Day backing off of him, respecting his drive, and he's decisive there. And that's always a tough distance to shoot it without using the board.
Lawson with the left hand. Slash into the hole.
A man-to-man defense now. They've mixed it up a little bit, showed some zone. And man-to-man. They try to challenge shots with their length, but that time didn't get close enough to the sweet shooting Wayne Ellington.
Boy, is he. That's his first basket of the night. The sweet shooter right here with the ball too, Gray. Goodson. Gets it out high to Day.
Well, you got to try to take Hansbrough off the dribble if you can.
Day shot. Bounces twice off the rim. And right to Hansbrough, who aggressively swings the arms and clears it for Carolina. Here's Ellington. Got fouled and caught the basket. Foul on Fargo. Seven different Tar Heels have already scored. And Ellington, after just hitting a three, has a chance for a three-point play the hard way.
Yeah, we were just talking, Jim, during the break, how he don't. Gonzaga back in the zone defense. Fargo sits down with the two fouls.
Lawson back out there, puts up the shot, gets another one. Now in double figures. Both teams shooting over 50%. But North Carolina has not committed a turnover here 12 minutes into the game.
That's the difference, partner.
Bolden tried for the clever pass. Picked off. Lawson hits the deck.
So strong and so aware of where he is and where the defenders are. He knew Goodson was coming. Measured his steps, got his body between the ball and the defender, and then concentrated to finish. And he's so strong. I mean, you got to go through his barrel chest and his low center of gravity, and you can't leave him open like that.
Oh, another three.
You can't leave him open now. You used to be able to. That was 2 years ago, though.
Got that perfect rotation going on those shots, too.
Yeah, well, you don't need rotation if you're not going to hit the rim on him.
Blocked by Danny Green. That was great driving to the basket.
But no, he's really worked to improve his shot, Jim. You make an excellent point about his rotation. It's textbook.
That was Hansbrough taken away from Bolden. Quick passing, and Allison Davis in for two shots. Foul on Heif. Austin driving on Bolden. Now shut down, goes back outside. Ellington, step back three, and he's got nine on the night.
Oh my, what a shot. This guy is shooting it with so much confidence here.
Heitfeld far away from the basket. Tough pass. He was trying to feed Day, who really wasn't open. Here's Ellington coming in on the wing. And Ellington with two more. He's in double figures yet again. Ellington, 23 straight games in double figs. Wayne Ellington.
Mr. Smooth. He can step back and knock down the jumper contested. He gets out in transition.
And he's doing a shot situation.
You want to try to get it up on the rim at about the 4 or 5 second mark so you have a chance for a second shot if you miss.
Hansbrough got Day to commit. Puts up the shot off the glass. And we reach the half with Hansbrough's basket, lifting the lead to 11. North Carolina's biggest lead was.
See, Austin Day is playing behind Deion Thompson. He's allowing him to catch that ball in way too deep.
Hansbrough now with 11. Pargo saddled with 3 fouls in that first half, unable to hit the three. Puts up the shot and hits it. How about the speed of Lawson, the quickness? It looks like it's almost all the way back.
And then the balance. He stopped on a dime there. Gonzaga really rushing it now.
Yeah, Gonzaga's not hit a shot now to start the second half.
And not even looking inside, Jim. Just settling for perimeter shot.
Oh, that is Lawson setting up Thompson. First 6 points of the half go to Carolina. Bolden long with the shot.
Ty Lawson really looks good. That's a good look for Green.
Green's second three of the game.
Yeah, he is so good trailing the fast break. When Lawson pushes it up and defenders run to the paint, when Green is the trailer, that's an excellent shot opportunity for him from behind the three-point line.
Now got their largest lead of the night. It has swelled to 19.
Doing a really nice job defensively, not allowing Gonzaga to get anything really inside. Active double team here.
Heitfeld, trouble all the way. Big numbers for North Carolina. Bounce pass, Ellington. Lawson with another assist.
How beautiful was that? The efficiency of it made it so good.
And Lawson's sitting down, but watch this little moment earlier.
Yeah, look at the maestro. He knows he's got Wayne Ellington on the wing, slows up his dribble, and leaves it for him beautifully. Excellent on Lawson, both playing with 3 fouls. Is that right, partner?
That's right.
Yeah, so this is a critical stage here. Pargo has been very good getting into the lane. Oh, good call, good screen that time for Frazier.
And Bobby Frazier, the senior with a 3-point basket.
Well, it's so hard when you're fighting to come back. The team on top, in this case, Carolina, just has to, again, wreck a couple of rallies to
stay in control.
Got the shot they wanted. Gray open on the wing. Now Ellington with that long stride. Can Frazier make it two in a row?
Yes! Bobby Frazier! Unexpected six-point boost. It's 26-second stretch. Pardo and Davis says not this time. Up ahead, Ellington. And just like that, basket counts. Heading to the line. North Carolina opens it back up again. A break in the action just after Gonzaga tried to climb back in it. The Tar Heels, led by Frazier, open it up.
Lawson to Hansbrough, and one coming up. Heitfeld on the hack.
Boy, North Carolina just has so many different ways and players that can hurt you.
Three on Heitfeld. Hansbrough now with 15 on the game.
Look at the strength of that finish. Knew he was going to receive contact. Didn't shy away from it. Accepted it and then shot through it.
Yeah, he's got that look too. Lawson feeds it Green from the wing. And he's got three threes on the night. Three out of six.
Well, he had been struggling. Taylor Griffin, Tony Crocker went for a career high tonight. You think about him and Danny Green perhaps matching up. Wayne Ellington has been terrific.
Oh, what a shot.
What a shot.
I didn't think he had the angle.
Or the strength, but he had both.
There's your final, 98-77 for Clark Kellogg. This is Jim Nance saying so long from Memphis. We'll send you to Greg Gumbel after these messages. This has been a presentation. Carolina taking the floor here in Memphis, Tennessee, bound to challenge the Oklahoma Sooners. The one and the two, they made it all the way here to the regional final. Let's give you a little more.
Thompson loose underneath. He had a shot there and elected to pass up on it.
Well, maybe after all there on his first attempt, he thought otherwise. He's going to take this one, though, and he knocks it down.
Hey, when you're a post player with his kind of shot.
They say it was before the shot, so Carolina inbounds. Here's Ellington. He takes his jumper, and it's all net. He is on a roll for more than a month.
Okay. Point line is going to have to really be a factor for his team here today.
It's Lawson. He's past Johnson. He waits. He sees Griffin, so he kicks it out. Three-point shot. Danny Green drills it. 7-0 North Carolina. Back to Davis. Blake Griffin defending. Over Blake Griffin, and it rolls in.
And Davis.
Ed Davis off the bench with a basket. Now it's Blake Griffin. Reach and stolen by Hansbrough. Fourth turnover against Oklahoma. Lawson, pull-up jumper, yes!
Beauty.
Double-digit lead already. Heels coming out hot. They lead it 13-2.
He gets his hands on it, it's his.
Warren's pass deflected and saved in the corner by Lawson. Danny Green in the paint, hits the shot. Hansbrough is running over to check in. He's been sitting down for over 4 minutes. Ed Davis gets another chance. And Danny Green flies in, takes it away, gets the putback. What an effort by Danny Green.
Terrific effort to pursue that orange. And that's all offensive rebounding is about, Jim. Try to wear down Oklahoma a bit.
Zeller snaps it over. Blake Griffin went for the steal. Actually, it was his foul on Leary, and Hansbrough with a dunk of his own. Four on the shot clock. Crocker has to take it at one.
You called it, partner. They passed up some really good looks and then got a forced one at the end of the shot clock.
Oh. Green shot somehow bounces in for a three. Just put a dead ball up there on the rim. That's a bone. Talk about bonus. Four on the shot clock now. Double up on Blake Griffin. And again, Crocker has to force it. Not in time. No shot, in fact, at all attempted. And the shot clock violation.
Jeff Capel wondering.
Big part of the story here, partner.
He has been. He's as versatile as baking soda. He gives you a lot of different good uses. Getting it off the dribble on the offensive glass. And having a terrific first half. And he had been in.
There's Griffin.
Yeah, it is. And actually, as my younger son would say, the number, the score is flipped, Dad. 32-23.
Ellington adds to the Carolina lead and is back to 11. Lawson weaving, dishing. Thompson has two baskets to start the second half after making one in the first half.
Well, that was a bounce.
Lawson loses it. Back to Thompson. He's sealed. Snaps it outside. Ellington's ready for it. And knocks it down for a three.
Surprising number, the fact that Oklahoma is out-rebounded North Carolina. North Carolina has gotten some second chance opportunities going, attacking this zone. And that's not going to work. They're going to have to go back to man-to-man because.
Let's come back and get this team turned around. By the way, he's done that against North Carolina.
Yeah, he sure has.
Lawson trying to add to it. And does with a three.
Well, I talked about it.
The entire half has been played between a 9 and 15 point Carolina lead. And Carolina comes up with the play. Taylor Griffin saying, wait a minute, where was the foul? Up ahead, though. Is Lawson racing in for two more?
Just overpowered Austin Johnson that time.
North Carolina and Oklahoma met in the tournament back in 1990. Dean Smith down in Austin against Billy Tubbs. And Oklahoma was ranked number one in the country. The number one seed in its region. And Rick Fox knocked him out.
North ball, and then you want to attack here at about the 10-second mark. Get ready to execute your play and put it in the hands of your playmaker.
That's Danny Green. Stepping up and banking it home.
Perfect execution there, and you'd expect that from an experienced team like North Carolina.
Going to be the case. North Carolina too much. They start out 7-0 and never look back. Tar Heels win for the 100th time in their history in the NCAA tournament, a record, and now a record 18th Final Four coming up. Good evening, friends, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to Detroit for tonight's second national semifinal game.
Remember us?
We're back.
You want tradition? You want dedication?
You found the right team.
We're motivated.
We're hungry.
We're back to claim what's ours.
We are Carolina.
Expect North Carolina to try to punch this ball inside at every opportunity.
Cunningham and Hansborough, a lot of shoving in that matchup. Ellington, oh, that one went way up into the sky and came down true for Wayne Ellington. Carolina's first.
Up here, they're able to hold their ground and they flick balls away from you.
Lawson with the three and he bangs it home. It's almost like it's a set shot. He gets that perfect rotation, gets a little separation. And
Jim, keep an isolated camera on number 10 from Villanova, Corey Fisher. He can go on individual scoring runs all by himself. He's that kind of explosive offensively.
Big East sixth man of the year. Meanwhile, Ellington has another basket. This one a three. Thought he would take it. That's batted right back to Lawson. Hansborough going to challenge Cunningham. That Hansborough shot we've seen for 4 years from the hip.
Yeah, and Cunningham unable to bother it. Showed some full court pressure out of the timeout the last trip. So both coaches trying to mix things up a little bit.
Danny Green, he launches. Knocks it down, Danny Green.
Well, he's been solid in the tournament, Jim. if in fact the steal isn't made.
Hansbrough makes the move to get the open shot for two more, and it's a quick 9-point Carolina advantage. This with his first. Here's the Carolina story from three.
Well, that was a warm-up jump shot for Ty Lawson. No defender in sight. Quick trigger from Danny Green. Jump shot of his. He'd like to space the floor and spread out the defense and then try to drive you on ball reversal.
Oh, it's Lawson. With the steal in the basket. 21-10 North Carolina. Anderson. That's Hansbrough battling Clark and coming away with it. There's that Lawson speed to the hole. Tapped up and in.
Well, Jay Wright talked about his team needing the rebound when we visited with them yesterday. Drive and dish.
And Ellington. And he too hits an outside shot. That's his second three. 26-12. In rhythm early. 26-12. Start. Cunningham hitting another outside jumper. This time they close in on Hansbrough. He kicks it out to an open Ellington with a three. Yes!
You can't gamble and make mistakes against these guys. Ellington's loving.
And he can shoot. When he gets that rhythm going, they've never lost a game when he shot 50% from the field in his career.
Well, he's been on a rip, like I said, for about 2+ months. I mean, he's been right in rhythm.
Weaving past three players. Thompson inside and got it this time.
Well, that's terrific persistence by Deion Thompson. How about the nifty ball handling by Lawson to avoid three defenders and then leave it for Thompson. And when he missed it inside, he was the first.
Back, all the North Carolina starters got on the board early in this game, all in the scoring column.
Well, they all average double digits on the regular season, Jim, the five starters. And they do it because they share the ball. They've got shooters. They've got guys that can go up and finishers up front. I mean, they've got the full package offensively. But I think it's the experience and the unselfishness that allows them to produce the points they do and the pace of play. They're now fouling. See, that's the next thing they've got to be able to accomplish in order to try to make a run before halftime.
Danny Green got the feet set and another three. 10, we'll give him 6 now, 2.
Called play out of the timeout. Cunningham there.
He's hit it several times tonight, but not that time. Now Lawson, working it underneath. Back out Green, 3, yes. Danny Green.
Well, they missed that when he was on the bench with the 3 fouls in the first half. Look at that 3-point shooting for the Tar Heels. Wow. Well, Villanova maintaining contact.
Redding lost it. Up ahead, Lawson. Reynolds picks up a foul. The basket, they haven't signaled good yet. I think it's gonna, it does, it counts.
Off the turnover, North Carolina makes you pay. Because when that guy gets it, Ty Lawson explodes to the basket.
Third
with poise foul. And strength.
Third on Reynolds.
Oh, they don't make it number 5, I'm sure. Nice penetration and another tough shooting break for Villanova.
They've missed the last 7 shots, Clark.
And 3 of them were high quality.
And Danny Green has broken their heart twice here in the second half.
Well, Danny Green has found his... Well, Villanova's only chance is to scramble this thing up with a frenetic defensive effort. And they've got to try to do it without fouling.
Davis with the basket and a free throw coming up.
Villanova just not patient enough in their attack off the dribble, Jim. They're best when they space the floor and move that ball side to side and then dribble penetrate.
And Lawson on net. Back to 16. Back to the line. What do you see out of Lawson tonight?
Everything we've come accustomed to seeing from him. Taking what's available. picking his spots and producing at a high rate of efficiency. You know,
Pena had a chance at it, but Davis takes it away. 11 straight misses from outside the arc. Here's Ellington. Not for the North Carolina side. His first second half points. Anderson waiting, waiting, waiting. Clean block, Green. Clean block, Thompson.
Wow.
Carolina comes out with it.
That's an example of what I mentioned a moment ago, the size of North Carolina really bothering interior shot opportunities for Villanova.
And Ellington drains another from long distance. And now North Carolina has its largest lead of 18. How about North Carolina three-point shooting tonight?
45% they came into the game shooting in the tournament. And they did nothing to hurt that tonight because they're right about 50% right now. Ellington, Green has made.
Because sometimes there's so many of these things that like go one way, but you set something up the other way for Monday night. But Carolina's 4-0 and his heels rolling on to Monday night. Another convincing Carolina victory. See the national championship game. Michigan State and North Carolina about to tangle for the title here on CBS.
Kalen Lucas starts out on him man-to-man. Walton is on Ellington.
Thompson with a freshman defending and perfect shot by Deion Thompson for North Carolina.
Jim, he only took 5 shot attempts in that game. Jim, only 1 in the first half on Saturday. Made 2 of them.
It's the 3. Here's Green with 1. And a swish by Danny Green. For the 3rd straight time in the title game, North Carolina faces a Big Ten opponent. It's Ellington slicing through and using the glass. Raymar Morgan had a monster night in the semifinal game Saturday. 18 points, 9 rebounds, and North Carolina comes right answering back.
And a steal on the inbounds pass.
Lawson feeds Thompson, and Sutton reaches in.
Boy, North Carolina is really on top of its game right now, Jim.
With that prestigious Kruse Award, and I don't think many people watching the tournament would doubt that he was the most meritorious honoree.
Without question, Jim.
Ellington hits the 3. And already North Carolina, there's that opening run we talked about. But in transition, Spartans get it up ahead for the easy layup by Draymond Green.
It's really pick your poison with North Carolina. I think Michigan State has to try to choke off the three-point shot and make this team a two-point shooting team. But right now, North Carolina making threes and making twos. Ed Davis, and this is where you have to be careful against North Carolina. Good job by Michigan State to choke off Lawson's penetration.
But it's back to Lawson. He gets past Lucas, and he'll take the baseliner well short. Davis, though, race to the rebound, picks it off the floor and scores. And a steal right back by Lawson. Frazier comes in, step up, three, no. But again, offensive rebound leads to two more for North Carolina. Wayne Ellington.
Tough matchup here. Corey Lucas defending Ty Lawson.
Hawkins got the advantage, and he's heading to the line for a three-point opportunity. Sutton on the foul.
What a second. What a time for Deion Thompson to play the way he's played most of the season.
And he's heading to the line for a three-point.
Look at this nice post-up position, though. Sutton playing behind him allows him to get sweet real estate inside. And then it's just a pivot and a finish. And Sutton
becomes a 20, thanks to their inside play.
Points in the paint. Off penetration here from Ellington. Beautiful move, and then a weak side rebound. Deion Thompson's been the star for North Carolina. But all...
Sutton's on the floor with two fouls. Davis.
Too much size for the freshman, Draymond Green. Just threw it right over top of him.
Ellington, he gets to that spot so fast, it knocks it down with a rainbow. Timeout. 12 points. 12-point win back in the regional final against Oklahoma and Blake Griffin. Down in Memphis. Here's Ellington. He's got another three. Feed it to Green. And that's a charge. Nothing to second.
Terrific job of rotating by Deion Thompson.
Run it up tonight.
Well, for the tournament, he has averaged 19 points a game on 50% shooting. He's made 14 threes coming into tonight's game, and he's added to that total with a couple here in the first half.
This jump between now and next season with strengthening and conditioning and playing more basketball during the summer.
Ellington, uncontested. North Carolina has a record first half total in the history of the championship game.
No rush for North Carolina. Very content to just run through their options in the half court.
Yep, hits the shot this time. Look at Lawson with all these thefts tonight.
Well, he's got seven of them. He just does a good job. Some of those were just thrown right to him, though. But he does a good job tracing the ball, we call it.
Drill. And that slides off the rim. Rebound goes to Summers. Stolen, there it is, the record. That's number 8 for Lawson, an all-time championship record. And Davis somehow got the shot to go, almost tapped it in volleyball style, and he's going to the line.
Has eased off the throttle a little bit.
Yes, they have. They missed their last 5. But you can end that streak thanks to Danny Green. He's had a knack for doing that. Anytime there's been even a little drought. I'm sure we'll see
yeah,
one.
Oh, yeah, I'm sure, too.
He's not going to let those kids down. That's what he said. I promise. Lawson to Hansbrough.
Well, he is so good at navigating.
Just 5 of 19 this half. Under 30%. Hansbrough.
Tough shot.
Improves the percentage and moves to number 4 all-time in tournament scoring. Tony Green. The ones really recognized tonight to govern play here at the championship game. Congratulations. And there's Lawson. And right in his hands, he acted like he had only 7 seconds.
Well, he saw the seam, Jim, and got right to the rim. He's so...
Stolen. Here's Bobby Frazier. Let Frazier take it in. There you go. He was a starter as a freshman, that team that had the rebuild. Made all ACC freshmen.
Roy Williams wants to get his reserves in as well. Tyler Hansbrough, look at that.
Oh, there it
excitement.
Is. C.B. McGrath, give him a hug. Steve Robinson, another assistant. Holiday.
And that joy. Look at that young man.
Marcus Skinner. They've been together for 4 years. Hansbrough has what he wanted. There's his father. From the start, that could not have been any finer. North Carolina is the 2009 national champion.
Welcome back to Detroit, Michigan, everyone. There is your final score. Let's get you back down to the court for the presentation of the NCAA trophy. Jim Nance and Clark Kellogg standing by with the national champions. Jim.
We're back here with the presentation of the national championship trophy. That's going to be in the hands of the North Carolina Tar Heels. And here to present it is the chair of the Division I Men's Basketball Committee, Mike Slive. Mike.
Thanks, Jim. Ladies and gentlemen, on behalf of the NCAA and Dr. Miles Brand, to whom we all send our very, very best wishes, and on behalf of the Men's Basketball Committee, I want to congratulate both teams for a great season, a great tournament run, and a great performance tonight. And now, it's my pleasure to present the 2009 National Championship Trophy to Coach Roy Williams and the North Carolina Tar Heels.
Everybody get a piece of that.
That feeling of putting your hands on that trophy another time. I look around, Coach, and I see tears in the eyes of your players. You can just tell the unity you had. It's something very special, and we saw it on the floor tonight.
Well, Jim, all year long, everybody's anointed this team, and they played their tail off. We had a couple of bumps in the road. They handled injuries. They handled some losses. Only thing I know is the youngsters standing behind me are great, great young men. I'm the luckiest coach in America, I can tell you that.
And I know on a night like tonight, you not only think of these kids, but you're thinking of Coach Smith also.
I think of two things. I think of my family that's put up with me so many nights watching tape and being gone. And I do think of Coach Smith. Coach, hope you're watching. Hope you're enjoying this moment.
Clark Kellogg, you are standing by here with the most outstanding player at the Final Four, Wayne Ellington.
Congratulations, Wayne. I know you're emotional. Talk about what this feels like. Is it what you anticipated? Because I know you guys focused on this from the end of the semifinal loss last year. This is where you guys wanted to be. Tell me how you're feeling now.
It feels great. You know, you never know what this feeling feels like until you experience it. It's something that you really can't explain.
What did you think about as you had the tears flowing there just a little bit ago?
I thought about how hard we worked. You know, we've been working so hard since last year when we fell short. And we wanted to redeem ourselves. We worked so hard. And I was proud of all my teammates, my coaches. It feels great.
Congratulations, Wayne. Jim, take it away.
Thank you, Clark. And Tyler Hansbrough, what a way to close out one of the most decorated careers in the history of college basketball. Congratulations.
Thanks a lot. This is the best way to go out. I mean, I couldn't picture it any other way. I mean, you know, what we've been through this year, and we climbed and we did it.
You did it, and Ty Lawson, you did it too. You set a championship game record with 8 steals tonight. Talk about this. You didn't know it, did you?
Yeah, I mean, I was just trying to get in the passing lanes and just slow down Kaelin Lucas today, and that was the main goal, and that's what I did tonight.
Listen, I wish we could talk to every one of you because you all contributed, but you're all national champions. The Nets belong to you, and so does one shining moment. Congratulations to the Tar Heels, the 2009 national champions.
Stay tuned, everyone. We're coming back with more from Detroit. One shining moment still on its way right after this.
for your life. You're a shooting star in all the years. No one knows just how hard you work. But now it's
look at these times.
It's Gibson for the lead.
With one downtown, yes!
That in one shining moment, you reach infinite. One shining moment, you knew you were alive. Feel the beat of your heart, feel the wind in your face. It's more than a contest, it's more.
Three to play. Here we go. Wisconsin drives in, hang it up, count it. 1 second. The long desperation.
Oh, my!
Spinning in traffic, leaning up, count it on the five.
Win or lose, you always hit your best. Cause inside you know.
Summers comes in
and tucks it right over Robinson somehow. Oh my goodness! In a one shining moment, you knew, yeah. In a one shining moment, you're willing to try. In a one shining moment, you knew.
A record crowd to see the championship, and we're underway. Thompson's got the advantage.
The size of Carolina, too much for Michigan State to handle.
The performance from the start that could not have been any finer. North Carolina is the 2009 national champion.